Welcome back, everyone. My name is Justin, and on this channel, we do VR tutorials. So today, I'm going to be talking about how to do a very simple reset of your VR player. So a lot of games sometimes need to have the player in a very specific spot. They need to know where the player is. So an example like this would be VTOL VR. So in VTOL VR, you are sitting in a cockpit, and the player has to be in a very specific spot. And so they give you this kind of reset feature, which is actually really nice and really well done. So you are sitting in a chair in like a briefing room, and then you hit the reset button and it will reset you to an exact point on the chair based on, you know, where you are in relation to your room. So today I'm going to show you how to set up that reset button. So let's jump into the computer and set it up. In this project, I'm going to be using the latest version of Unity, so that's going to be 2021.2.19f1. The F1 at the end just means it's a final version. And then I'm going to be using the 3D URP project to default that they give you, and we'll name this Player Reset. Now that we've got Unity up, I'm going to run through and set up the VR project using the XR Interaction Toolkit real quick. I've already done several run-throughs of this, and so in order to keep this video short, I'm just going to skip right over it. If you want a little more detailed breakdown of how to actually set that up, just check out the video in the top corner, or it's going to be linked down in the description as well. There we go. I've got the whole project set up, and we are using OpenXR as well as the XR Interaction Toolkit, as well as the sample starter asset pack that came with the XR Interaction Toolkit. So that's everything I'm using. But for this particular project and script and stuff we're going to go through, it will also work for Steam VR if you want to use that plugin instead, or even the new Oculus, their new interaction system. You can use it with that as well. So first things first, let me just kind of show you what I want to accomplish. So let me get my headset in link mode. And then if I hit play right now, you'll see that my camera moves around with my headset, obviously, and then I have my controllers as well. You can see in the scene view here that my camera kind of moves around, and if I even zoom in and get closer on this camera here, and then let me bring the icons down a little bit. There we go. So on the main camera, you can see it kind of moves around a little bit, but our starting point actually was right here. So this was the center point, and our camera kind of automatically starts above where the center point is. And you can kind of think of the camera as existing inside of a box. And so the XR Origin is not actually the player per se. Unity recognizes the XR Origin more as the room that you're standing in, not the actual player. So as I'm moving all of my camera around, by moving the headset, you'll notice that the position and rotation of the camera are moving, but the XR Origin, as I move my camera around, is not moving. It's staying in the same spot. So if I wanted to reset this camera by moving the headset, I actually can't do that manually off of the main camera, because I can't manually adjust any of these values. So see, as I try to move it, I can't move and drag or even type, you know, values in here, because as soon as I hit enter, it just resets back to wherever the actual headset is in relation to the XR Origin. So makes it a little more complicated than just setting the position and rotation of the headset. So what we're going to need to do, so let's say for instance I have a little sphere that I want to snap my headset to whenever I reset. I want my headset to snap exactly to that sphere wherever that sphere is facing. That's, you know, kind of what I want to do. So the idea is, okay, I'm going to have some kind of transform game object that I place, and whenever the player hits the reset button, the camera moves exactly to that spot. So in order to do that, we actually need to move the XR Origin. So you'll see when I move the origin position, the camera actually moves back and forth. And then the same applies for the rotation. So if I rotate around the Y axis, which is really the only axis you want to rotate around, you don't want to rotate, you know, the X or Z axis, because then things get really wonky. So just Y rotation, and then the position of the actual XR Origin is what we want to do. So let's write a script for this and figure out how to actually do it. I'm going to assume that you're going to want some kind of player controller. So we're going to throw this inside of your player controller. So I'm going to create a new script inside of my folder structure here. So right click, create new folder, and we'll call this scripts. And I accidentally put it inside of the XR folder, so I'll drag it back out into assets. And then inside of scripts, let's create a C# script. And we'll call this player controller. And this will house, you know, any of the other things you want the player controller to be able to do, but we really only need one method in order to accomplish this reset. And then I'll put the player controller on the player. And then I'll double click to open it. And my IDE is JetBrains Writer. So if you're a student, you can get free access to this IDE. It is very nice. Much better, in my opinion, than Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code. It integrates with Unity very, very nicely. I say that just so that you know that some of the coloring may be different and some of the IntelliSense. So like you won't see any of these markers that are popping up above in my code. Mine's a little more advanced, and just think of it like I have extra plugins in my IDE. But you should be able to type in all the things that I type and everything should work for you. And shameless plug, if you don't want to set this whole project up yourself, or if you don't want to type in all the code, you can get access to all of the source code from this project and all of the source code from any other previous project that I've ever done on my channel. It's all going to be on my Patreon, so there's a link down in the description. And I would really appreciate it if you contribute, because that helps me out, that helps the channel out, that helps me and motivates me to make more videos. So it benefits you, and I try to provide as much value as I can in the Patreon members, in the Discord, and direct messages, and just, you know, providing code and early access to videos. You get a lot of perks. So let's jump into this code. First thing I always like to do is clean up a little bit of the unnecessary things. So I'll delete those two using statements. And I'm actually just gonna delete both the start and the update methods for now. You can have them in your player controller if you like, and you're gonna use it for other things. But for this particular case, we don't need it. The only thing we actually need is we're gonna do a reset position method. So this is gonna be a public void reset position. And then we're gonna need three different public variables for this to, you know, actually function correctly. So we're gonna need the actual point that we want to reset the player to. That makes sense. We're gonna need the actual player location, so where their head is physically in the world. And then we're also going to need access to the XR origin, which is technically the most parent object of the player, but Unity kind of recognizes that as the room. So we basically need access to, all right, we're basically just gonna move the room in world space is what we're doing. We're gonna pick it all up, all the way up, and put it down somewhere else. And that should reset our camera to the correct place. Those variables are going to be all serialized fields. So we're gonna keep them private. We're gonna keep them private, but we want access to them in the inspector. So first is gonna be a transform, and this is just going to be the place that we want to reset the player to. So reset transform is what we'll call it. The next one is the player, so another serialized field, and this can just be a game object and we'll call it player. This will be the actual room, so the most parent object of the player, the XR origin in our case. And then finally serialized field, and then another game object, and then this is going to be the camera. So the camera of the player, which is we're gonna call it the player head. And now inside of reset position, we can do a little maths and actually, you know, move the room around and then the player inside of the room to the right spot. And the first thing we want to do is rotation. Make sure you do rotation first and then position, because the player may be, say, in the back corner of the room. And then if you rotate the whole room, then the player is going to move all the way over to this side of the room. And so you'll have to reset the position again. So always rotate first, and then you can reset the position. It's less things. So the first thing we need to figure out is what is the angle of the place we want to reset to, the reset transform, and then what is the angle of the player's head. And then we're basically just going to apply the difference, and that's where the player is going to be facing. So we're going to do a var rotation angle, and this is just going to be y because we only care about the y-axis. We don't care about moving the, we don't want to tilt the whole room. We just want to rotate it on the y-axis. So we're going to take the difference between the player head. So we always use the player head as the reference because that's where the actual camera is. And then the transform on that camera. And then the rotation on that transform. And then Euler angles, which basically converts our quaternion rotation to a vector 3 of angles. And then we only care about the y-axis of that angle. And then we're going to subtract that by the reset transform version of that. So reset transform dot rotation dot Euler angles dot y. And this will give us the difference between the angles. So we are getting the rotation angle, so it's basically the difference between the player's head and the reset transform, and then all we need to do is actually apply this angle. And we're going to do that on the player, so player dot transform dot rotate, and this applies a specific rotation, and we give it a vector 3. And in this case, we want a 0 on the x-axis, we want a rotation angle y on the y-axis, and then a 0 on the z-axis. You'll actually notice, since I've already tried this out before, I've noticed that you actually have to invert this rotation angle. You'd either invert it here, or you could swap these back and forth and basically just cut this and put it here, and then just say reset transform.rotation, and then this can be the positive value. So either way, if your player is actually, you know, facing further away from the, you know, rotation that you're intending, then just try flipping the sign in front of here as well. You'll also notice that my code editor adds in this IntelliSense here, so it automatically knows that this is the x angle, this is the z angle, this is a float. This isn't actually code. This is just something, you know, that it's telling me. It recognizes, okay, this is going to be a float. And so I say this just so you don't actually type in colon float, because that will give you errors. So if you see anything that's like grayed out, make sure not to type that part. All right, so we have rotation. So this should rotate you to face the correct direction, but you're going to be pointed the right direction, but facing the, but in the wrong position. So we want to remedy the position now. So var, this is going to be the distance. And we'll call it distance diff, the difference between the distances. And then we're going to do the reset transform dot position subtracted by the player head dot position dot transform dot position. And I'll make that on the new line just so it's easier to see. And then all we have to do is add that distance to the player dot transform dot position. So we're going to do plus equals, which basically just means add whatever's after this to the existing thing. And we'll say distance difference. So you'll notice a pattern here. We're trying to find the difference between the reset transform and the player head, but instead of applying the difference to the player head, we're applying it to the actual player, which in this case is the room that we are existing in at the moment. And that's all you need. This few lines of code is all you really need, and you just need to call reset position whenever you press a button or, you know, some action occurs. All you have to do is call reset position and it will automatically reset your player. And if you're interested in getting into button presses and figuring out how that works, then I have a video that you can also check up here in the top corner, and it will show you how to, you know, actually apply different methods and stuff on a button press. But in this particular case, we're going to do a really easy thing that is called the context menu. And we're just going to call this reset position. Make sure you save. And all this allows me to do is right click on the actual script and then click a button and swap over to it. So it's makes it easy. All right, so over on our XR Origin, you'll see we have our player controller. And now if I right click, you'll see reset position is there. And so when I click on this, it is actually going to call our method. So it goes ahead and calls the method. So that's what context menu does here. And again, don't type item name colon or vector 3 colon or any of these if you're following along. And last thing we need to do is set up the actual inspector thing. So the reset transform is going to be where we want to set our object to. So we're just going to create a sphere. We'll call it reset point. And I'll actually reset that to the center, and I'm going to scale it down as well. And actually, just for fun, we're going to move it over here, and then we're going to rotate it around a little bit. There we go. So it's, you know, kind of offset and then kind of pointing in a slightly different direction. And then I'm actually just going to duplicate it and then move another sphere out just so we make sure we are, because we're going to, our camera's going to be right at this point, and so I just want to make sure we're facing this other reset point when we move, just to make sure we're oriented in the right direction as well when we're testing. So back to the script, we're going to drag and drop the first reset point, so the actual one we want to move to. And then the player is going to be the XR origin. And then the player head is the main camera. And you can set these up in the start and awake methods to automatically set themselves. And so you don't have to do this. There are many ways and approaches to do this. This is just a very simplified, dumbed down tutorial version of, you know, this is how you get it working at the bare minimum. And then you can go back in and add in some, you know, whatever is best for your game and performance. So now, if I hit play here, I don't even have to put the headset on because I put a little piece of tape on the back of the sensor there. And so I can just move it around and the headset thinks that I'm wearing it, which is nice, so it doesn't turn off. So there we go. And you'll see in our scene view that I'm actually way up here at the moment. So if I click off, and keep in mind if I click off of the scene view or the game view, it's going to pause the game, and so my headset won't orient. So we'll see if I right click here and see now it stopped orienting. So it's just you need to make sure your headset is where you want it to be when you right click, and then that'll do it. And then we hit reset position, and there we go, where you are facing. You'll see that my camera is actually pointing in the direction of the second ball, which is correct. Here, I'll move the scene view over a little bit just so we can see that a little better. So if I put the camera down and over here, right click, reset position, you'll see I'm pointing in that direction. And even the controller's lines are pointing in that direction now because they haven't been set. So if I move over here, right click, reset, and it moves my camera and angles it the correct angle every single time. So you can imagine how useful this would be in certain games, especially games that require some kind of sitting, like a NASCAR game, or you know, racing of some sorts like that, or flight simulators, anything where you have to be stationary, but the player has to be in a very specific spot. This is very useful to know how to reset the player to a specific spot. And it's a little more difficult than it might seem right off the bat. You can't just, you know, set the player's position to whatever point position you want it to be. You actually have to do a little bit of math in there. So just wanted to, you know, show you how to do this real quick. If you want to just download this project or download the .unity project and add it to your existing project, then join the Patreon. I have all those files for you available. And if you are trying this out yourself and you run into issues, then join the Discord. We have a dev help channel for you to ask your questions in. And otherwise, I really appreciate you watching the video, and I'll see you in the next one.